I don't want to offend the massive fan base.
If you mess this up, bro, the Shadow and Bone fan base will come for you, and I don't want that for you. I want you safe, so just be careful.
Okay.
I'm just warning you.
Hey everyone, my name is Philip Wang. Welcome to another episode of Spill the Boba Tea, a show where I get to invite a special guest over to Bopomofo Cafe to make a drink that's based on my guest's life and career. Today is super special because we have with us a rising star who has been literally kicking his way through Hollywood on his way to leading man roles. You've seen him in Mortal Kombat, Into the Badlands, Wu Assassins, and the new season of Netflix's hit show Shadow and Bone. He didn't come here alone, he brought his dad as well. Please welcome Louis Tan and his father, Philip Tan.
Yeah.
Look at this, guys. Your first guest that's like an action star, but it's also the first time that I have notes. I'm gonna be using notes this time, and I'm so embarrassed, but I had to because your resume is just insane. There's too much to kind of keep track, so I needed to bring some notes.
Yeah, and it's like 1/10 of his, so.
Right, and so that's the thing. We got a lot to go through today, so let's just jump right in. Well, the first thing that I want to bring out is this ingredient. And it's not really an ingredient, this is just something to just get us started. Take a look at that.
That's ginger.
Ginger.
It is ginger. You're right. It's pure, fresh ginger juice.
I love some ginger.
And just to start things off.
Ginger shot?
We're going to take a ginger
Let's
shot.
Let's go, baby.
Because, look at this bartender. He's Dude, you got the job already.
Shots.
As a stuntman, it's good to take care of your body. So I was like, hey, let's start things off with something that's really good for our body, which is ginger shots. Oh my God, those are heavy pours, man.
This is what, it's a little spice, too.
Thank you. This is what my wife drinks.
Oh my
morning.
Gosh.
Cheers,
Cheers,
guys. Right?
Oh my
Cheers.
God.
Bye. Cheers.
Woo. Oh yeah.
Oh my.
That's oh God. My God.
Spice up your life. Woo. No spice, no life. Woo. Come on. Get it down.
You got
oh
it.
Oh my God. What the hell?
I think we're ready to go. Yeah, we are ready to go. I mean, although we're here to talk about your acting, like we can't not talk about your stunts.
Right.
You started training him in martial arts.
Yeah, when he was very young.
Did you try anything else? Like, were you like, or was it just always martial arts? Was there any piano in there? Was there a violin?
It's trampoline, stunts, jump off the building.
Wow.
Aram.
Yeah,
we do everything.
For my talent show when I was in, what was it? Like, it must have been 7th or 8th grade.
Yeah.
I jumped off my school building.
Yeah.
Into an airbag.
Into an airbag.
It was like 40, 50 feet high.
Wait, so how does this work? Because it's a talent show, so like it's out.
I don't think it would happen now because insurance. I don't know how did they let us do that?
Well, because they said, look, you know, we're going to do something special. Yeah. Everyone had different things to do. You know?
Yeah.
I said, okay,
yeah, some people are dancing.
What? I'm going to do something that's very different. No one's ever seen it. And he's just going to jump off this building. And they're like, what do you mean? He's jump off the airbag. But look, don't worry. It'll be a surprise. I said, and action. He went, wah, bang. And then they like,
but that
oh
was
my
our,
God.
That was
oh
our
my
house.
God.
That was our house. You know, so my father obviously, you know, has done all these amazing action films. So in our backyard, we had all the stunt equipment that you would use on movies. We had airbags.
Right.
We had, you know, crash mats.
Porta pads, you know.
Trampolines, all sorts of different stuff.
I want to play a quick word association with you, okay? Because I'm going to go down some of the films that you did some stunts. And these are huge movies. I love that one of the first things on your resume is Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift.
Yeah. NSX.
NSX.
I was in the NSX, the yellow NSX. That was a crazy shoot. Yeah, man, it was cool. I was doing stunts as well on that. Did you work on that too?
Yeah, just a few days. Yeah.
You know, it's like we had the whole Asian stunt community.
Right.
Because it's, you know, it's,
and Justin Lin. Yeah.
Justin Lin, you had Sung Kang, and it's like the Asian Fast and the Furious. And at this point, the scene that we were shooting was Tokyo, but actually we shot it here in LA.
Right. All right, next one would be Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End.
Wet, dirty, wet. We were in the Bahamas for, this was right after I got out of college. I was in college for one day.
Right.
First day on campus, had all my classes scheduled. I got a phone call and they were like, hey, you know, do you want to come work on this movie, Pirates of the Caribbean? It's in the Bahamas. That was my last day. That was my last day in school.
Amazing.
That was it. I knew what I wanted to do, but you know, I thought maybe you should just get a degree and then go do it. But then Tarantino says the film school, his film school was film.
Right.
That was the best education I could have ever had.
We were on that one too,
together.
Right?
Yeah. I was in, you know, Bahamas together. That's and so cool. They asked me to pick a bunch of Asian, you know, that can do everything.
He picked me.
Hey, I know an Asian. Hey, I made an Asian.
I know that can act. You gotta be able to fight and play Asian.
Yeah.
I played the headless guy, you know, the guy
who
Johnny's chasing me all day long.
Oh my God.
I'm actually, you played the headless guy in a different movie, Pirates 4. This is Pirates. No, you did four back. Oh my god. No, not four.
I did two.
Look how amazing this conversation is when you and your dad can be arguing about which Pirates movie. Yeah.
I did two and three.
No, he was the headless guy. That's amazing. I remember.
Last one. Hangover Part 3?
Yeah, we were in a prison. Yeah, we had a huge like melee riot fight scene in a prison. There was just chaos, but yeah, so much fun.
Let's back it up just a little bit.
Yeah.
I want to talk about your guys' history in Britain. You were born there. You obviously like had a huge full career there too. And that's actually the inspiration of our next ingredients.
Okay.
This is Earl Grey tea.
There you go.
You moved when you were pretty young.
Yeah.
How often do you go back? Do you miss it?
I'm back all the time. Yeah. And yeah, I miss it dearly. It's family.
You just got back from there.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
okay.
I didn't grow up around them as much. So for me, now that I'm older, it's important for me to connect with my roots and my heritage and be around that, you know?
You know, obviously here in America, there's a lot of dialogue about being Asian American, like the identity and what we have to go through in Hollywood. Are there a lot of similarities or crossovers of what maybe British Asians are kind of going through, or what do you feel?
No, 100%. You know, I started in 1979. That's how long ago. Just me going to audition, and I used to talk like this. All right, Phil. Yeah. All right, mate. You want a cup of tea?
Yeah.
I'm from London.
Right.
Yeah. And I'm going for this job as an actor. Right.
Yeah, right.
They go, do you speak Chinese accent?
Yeah, they
can you
the
do
accent.
Chinese accent?
Mm, yeah.
And I said, of course, I'm an actor.
Yeah.
And I just switch, right?
At that time, it wasn't like a problem to do an accent. You didn't think really twice about it.
No, you don't want
it to work.
Yeah.
You just want to work. And there's no work.
There's no opportunities.
Yeah, there's maybe 50 to 100 stunt guys, actor going for the one job.
Yeah.
With two lines.
But I experienced that same thing earlier in my career. It's only recently where things have changed.
Sure. Yeah.
And they haven't even changed fully. They've definitely progressed.
There's progress, That's
huge progression for sure, for certain.
I want to talk about this, like, you know, kind of crossover from Britain to America, because Philip, you had to make that jump. And that's the inspiration for our next ingredients. You came over for a small movie called Batman Returns.
No, Batman.
Batman, sorry.
The original Batman.
The original Batman. But you were the stunt coordinator for Batman Returns.
No, the Batman, the first one.
Tim Burton's Batman.
Yeah. I did do Batman Returns as well.
This happens to me all the time.
He's just done too many things. If you scroll on his IMDb, you're like this.
Listen,
it's hard to...
Before I came here, I had to look at my own credit because I don't remember. So many, I don't remember.
All right, now I feel less bad.
Don't feel bad.
Because our next ingredient is inspired by the villain of Batman Returns, Catwoman.
Is that coconut milk?
It's 2% milk. It's simple. 2% milk, but she was drinking some 2%. Yeah, I just wanted to like kind of go back in time to when you first came to America and like for these jobs. And what was the industry like for you like back then? First of all, how much of Batman did you already know about?
When we first did it, we shot a lot of the stuff in the UK.
Yeah.
And then it was so good. You know, John Peters and Mark Canton and Peter Grobel, they brought me here and said, like, we'll not take no for an answer. We're going to come to America. You're going to do the premiere. So we came over, brought Lewis over. You know, that's how it all happened.
Well, from your perspective, like, was that, like, what was going through your mind? Like, oh my God, I'm going to Hollywood. I'm going to Batman. Oh my gosh. Like, or.
I was quite young. Yeah, I went to the premiere.
Batman t-shirt.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I grew up with them, you know, Batman stuff all over the house. Of course, as a kid, you're like, this is the most amazing thing ever. When you watch the movie, your dad is like fighting the superhero. It was incredible. It was inspiring for sure. It was more of like an education and a introduction to this beautiful world of like storytelling and filmmaking and all the creative, you know, behind it.
Yeah.
But he was playing a bad guy his entire career. Yep. You know, he was playing these roles where I didn't see myself being like, oh, I can play the hero. Yeah. I thought, oh yeah, I can probably fall in line with that, you know.
Because that was all that was available to us for a very long time.
I didn't see an Asian hero role until much later, until maybe, you know, just
it
recently.
It was Bruce Lee and then nothing.
Yeah. Well,
it
was, and nothing.
Yeah, it was Bruce, Jackie, and then not much. Yeah. But even then, that's not really my generation.
Right, so I think that's really interesting that you bring that up, that, you know, you grew up in this industry, you're feeling like, hey, I belong here, but then when you start going out for roles, you're like, oh no, I can only get in with these specific roles. Was there a time when that was kind of deflating to you and kind of discouraging, or were you just trying to say, hey, I'm just one step at a time, I'm just trying to get up?
No, it was, I mean, I'm a very ambitious person and I have this kind of like fire that was driving me to do this.
Yeah.
I think I became a little bit crazy and obsessed for a while to like accomplish this. It was no walk in the park. I mean, there was times for years that I couldn't get, you know, a good role, or I would get really close to booking a lead role and I would lose it to a Caucasian actor. And it would just happen all the time because at that time, the industry wasn't prepared to do that. Casting people would see you and then they'd keep you in mind, but then you would never get that chance, you know?
And he would read better than the Caucasian actor, and they would give it, they wouldn't give it to him. And I'm like, I saw the audition. Yeah. I know what's good, and I'm not trying to be biased.
Yeah.
But he,
a little bit biased.
You know, but you gotta just tell him the truth. But I knew he had the drive, and I also know there's a void.
Yeah.
And he wanted to fill that void, which is be the lead actor, the good-looking guy that can fight, yeah, that can act, he can, you know, do his own stunts.
Right. I wanted to, you know, bring up one kind of big moment for you. I don't know if it's gonna be a painful memory.
Oh, here we go.
We're gonna do a drink that has a blender in it.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
And the reason why is I want to talk about a character that you played in the Marvel Universe named Shatterstar.
Oh God. Yeah. Okay.
I'm not just here to bring up like sad memories of your character getting blended, but you recently tweeted, you know,
I got hacked that day, man.
Oh really?
I was hacked.
Oh really?
Yeah, I was hacked. I don't know what. I'm not quite sure what you're talking about.
Okay. Well, you know, I'll just leave this here.
Listen, that character has gotten so much attention, like online and social media,
yeah,
that the people have spoken. So that's all I'm gonna say.
I don't want to get you in any more trouble, so I'm just gonna leave this here for us to just always remind that we're thinking about it.
Yeah.
We're thinking about it.
I am too.
Okay, we don't have to talk about Shatterstar anymore, but what I do want to talk about is Cole Young. There is another amazing movie that kind of came out around this time that, you know, you're getting into the movies and you have this amazing role in this amazing IP, Mortal Kombat. How did it feel to step into like the world of Mortal Kombat?
I mean, it was very daunting. I think I said no the first time I read the script. I'm like, I don't think I should be doing this. I don't know.
Why do you think that you weren't? Yeah.
It's partly what you said. It's partly the nerves. It's partly taking on such an iconic IP. I used to play that game
up until
2 in the morning when I was a kid, like with all my brothers. I wanted to make sure that it was going to be done well. It was going to be, you know, who was involved, the right people, and what could I bring to the table here?
Especially as a new character in the universe.
Well, that's the thing, you know, it's challenging. Mortal Kombat is a game where they bring new characters in all the time. So it wasn't really like adding a new character, but it was the thought of like having to be that new character in the face of Scorpion, Sub-Zero, Sonya, Jax, Raiden, all these amazing, Liu Kang, these amazing characters that are so iconic.
Yeah.
How could I be in that world and live there and actually like make a difference?
So you said that you actually played it as a kid growing up.
Oh yeah.
So were you pretty good?
Yeah. The arcade version?
Yeah.
Oh
yeah.
Down.
I even played it.
I was gonna say like
he just button. He just buttoned
that. They don't let kids play violent games, but at the same time, you're not a typical parent.
But I think they were a little freaked out when you saw the fatality and they were like ripping hearts out and stuff.
Oh yeah.
My mom wasn't happy.
I'm glad you brought that up because
you brought some hearts.
That's part of our, you know, the ingredients. Oh, so this is some blood.
Yeah.
All right. This is going
to
be...
That's integral to my career.
This is some guava pomegranate syrup here.
That.
All right. Next ingredient, we have this guy right here.
Oh, wow. That's very
nice.
Good. It's very good for if you have cancer. This thing is actually very, very helpful.
It's
That's the most Asian thing so far anyone has said.
If you have... it's dragon fruit.
Yeah.
And we also have some guava juice here as well. Guava nectar. And these fruits are very, very popular and common in Southeast Asia, which is where you shot Fistful of Vengeance.
Yes.
Which is an offshoot of your show, Wu Assassins. And that's when you kind of like really stepped into also a series regular role. What was it like, you know, getting to work with Netflix for that first time?
Yeah, well, it was really incredible. Also, that's another example of a show that they took a chance and they've hired, you know, all these really amazing Asian talents, Asian director. You got behind the scenes, you got cast, and it's a show that has Iko Uwais, who is an insane, amazing martial artist who taught me a lot on that series. So to get to work with him was incredible, and to get to be part of a project where they're telling original Asian stories. It's about a family that lives in San Francisco, you know what I mean? And it's like the trials and tribulations that you go through that aren't necessarily tied to just being Asian, they're just being human, you know? So like that type of experience, getting to be a part of a project like that, I mean, it was just phenomenal.
And it's Asian lead.
We're going to pause on the drink right now and play a quick game, actually.
Okay.
So we have this segment called Take Two on the show where I have some sides from some of your previous projects.
Okay.
Okay? We're just going to see how much of these scenes you still remember. No pressure, okay? But we are talking about Wu Assassins right now. Like, I'm testing, you know?
Yeah.
This is from episode 10, Wu Assassin finale. I'm gonna act with you if that's okay.
Okay.
All right. Exterior alleyway, night. Lucien goes outside for a smoke. Christine appears. Christine says, "Those things will kill you." But then again, you cheated death a few times.
This is where we're outside, right after she stole my car.
She's wearing a...
Oh, yeah, it's a nice dress.
Christine chuckles. Oh, wow. Wow, that like really got me, man. Lewis,
on,
chill,
man.
Okay, sorry, same character. Well, it's your line.
Nice dress, so where are you heading? Everyone's inside if you want to join.
Oh, no. If I went in there, there'll probably be a lot of talk about what happened, and I've been thinking about it too much as it is.
I've been thinking about it a lot too, so where are you going?
Where's this where you're going?
Just go with it, man.
Let's go with it. I'm going wherever you're going.
That's not what happened.
Wherever you're going.
I'm going where my car is because she owes me two cars.
I think I'm going to take a drive, you know, clear my head, figure things out, see what else is out there.
All right. You're going to leave those keys with me?
I hope you find peace, Lucien.
This is where we kiss. Is this why you picked that scene?
Oh.
I was wondering why he picked this kissing scene.
And cut.
I'm sorry, he needs some acting lesson.
I'm so sorry. I was throwing you off. It really was, if Christine were here, it would probably be a lot better. I apologize.
That's actually hard. I've never done that before. As soon as the script is, I'm like, I blank it out of my mind.
It's tough. The next ingredient is inspired by a pretty big show that you're part of, that's out right now, called Shadow and Bone.
Oh, yes.
And honestly, in doing research for this entire drink, I gotta say, this was probably the hardest one. You've been part of so many franchises that have so many worlds.
Yeah.
Is it hard to keep track of all these worlds? Because the names and the races and the nations are so confusing.
It's hard, man.
Yeah.
It's a lot. That's why I forget those lines.
Yeah.
Because I gotta make room for the next thing.
Because you don't have normal names either. Let me just tell you what I had to deal with in researching this, and you probably as the actor.
Well, this is a hard one because this is a best-selling book series.
So yeah.
So
I'm gonna
research.
I don't want to offend the massive fan base.
If you mess this up, bro, the Shadow and Bone fan base will come for you, and I don't want that for you. I want you safe. So just be careful.
Okay.
I'm just warning you.
Okay. So your character is named Tolya Yul-Batar.
Yes.
Okay.
That's correct.
Twin brother of Tamar Kir-Batar, formerly a mercenary member of the Sturmhans crew.
Sturmhans
crew. A member of the Soldat Soul.
Yep.
You're a Grishna Heartrender.
Grisha. Yep.
Grisha.
It's okay. You're there. You're there.
I'm like sweating right now, but it's like switch now. After the Ravkan Civil War.
Ravkin. That's all right.
Tolya becomes a member of the Nikolai Lanskov's personal guard. And you're from the nations of Ravka and Shuhan.
Shuhan, yeah.
Well done, well done.
This
and
is why I need to
I couldn't do it.
That's how I introduced myself.
Literally. Like, your power, your character has the power to affect organs and hearts.
Yeah.
And so I wanted to get an ingredient that was good for hearts. All right, we have some black sesame paste.
Oh.
The story and the lore just goes so deep.
Yeah.
Like, again, once again, you're stepping into a fandom that is so large.
Yeah.
Do you feel that pressure or are you feeling the love?
Similar to how you just, you know, felt
that. But what are you talking about? I aced that.
You did, you crushed it. There's so much to learn about that world, and Leigh Bardugo wrote such an incredible, you know, story. And yeah, there is a lot to learn, but I was just taking it step by step. And I think you trust those people that you're working with that they can help guide you. But I knew that I could bring something interesting to this character, and I really wanted to play a twin, and I thought that was really unique. Mm-hmm. And I love the way that they did the visual effects on the show. I love Eric's writing. I think he's phenomenal. So yeah, I was very excited to jump in there.
Yeah, you know, going back to what's, you know, the food that's good for your heart, your powers. I think in real life you actually do have the ability to affect hearts. You know, is it weird that you have like all these fans that literally see you as a heartthrob?
Well, you said it, not me.
I mean, well, it's also you've been casted as that too. Is it worth seeing your son being a heartthrob?
I say, thank you very much. Awesome. Yeah, I mean, even when he was two, I said, okay, this is a star. I know, because I work with stars all the time, and I know, boom, this guy is gonna hit.
Like, well, I wish you would have told me that when I was a kid, because that's not what you told me I was gonna be the part.
This is just like an Asian parent. Like, they have all this belief in you, but they'll never tell you.
But that's so funny, because now, but now that I'm actually doing it, son, I knew.
I knew
you were two.
This is why this episode is so special. You know, we got to bring your dad, and I know that your dad is actually a big part of, like, some of future plans of yours as well. Like, you wanted to make a film about your dad's history, because you have such an amazing, like, history yourself. Your path through the industry as gymnastics, through martial arts, through disco.
I was a national champion disco dancing champion. So I'm a national champion gymnast, martial art, and gymnastics in Great Britain.
How do you compete disco?
The Saturday Night Fever in the 70s, 80s was sweeping across the world, you know, from America with John Travolta.
Yeah.
So they would have competition. It's £5,000 for the winner. And then you come on and you dance. I won 7 national disco dancing title and a trip for two to Studio 54. You dance in front of the audience.
This is why he has to have a movie.
And this is also what I said. I said, that's a fantastic story, especially as a Chinese guy living in London.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, there's not a lot of Chinese disco dancing.
Who's this Chinese guy tearing up the dance
but
floor?
But also, I thought it was cool because he's adding in the martial arts, he's adding in the gymnastics while he was doing disco.
That itself deserves like a whole like line of drinks. But we're gonna start assembling this one right now, right?
Trust me. Might be smacking. Are you gonna put the ginger in it?
The ginger was just for us.
Keep the ginger out then.
All right. We're gonna put 1 cup of milk. All right, Lewis, do me a favor and pour 1 cup of the tea, please.
1 cup.
All right, and I'm gonna pour in 1 cup of the guava nectar. We have some frozen dragon fruit right over here.
Okay.
What we need next is we need our blood. So if you can, give me 2 shots of the blood right in there.
2 shots of blood.
So gory.
This is nothing, bro.
Ready to see how this goes?
Doesn't look bad.
It looks very good.
Will you do the honors, Philip?
3, 2, 1.
Whoa! Ooh.
This is what my shower water looks like every time I finish shooting.
So to finish this off, we're gonna actually use the black sesame to actually coat our cup. So what you're gonna do is kind of from the top, just like smear it.
Yeah,
and just
let it like the fold.
Let it naturally, the fold. Like, I know the fold.
Smear it up like this.
Yeah. Oh, look at this, good son doing it for his father, wow.
Thank you.
So let's see what happens. All right, here we go. Oh, ooh. Oh, oh my God.
That's how you do it.
That was not supposed to happen. Okay.
This happened because it's our drink.
Yes. And this is.
This is a representation.
Interesting.
Of my father's overflowing career.
What should we call this?
Shadow and bone.
Something with like the Tan family. Oh, he's already going in. Oh, what do you think?
Oh, good.
Cheers,
I like it.
Guys.
Cheers.
Cheers, mate.
To many more years.
Many more years of the Tan family. All right. Let's see how it tastes.
Not gonna lie, that is very good.
Hey.
And the hint of the tea.
Yeah, and a little bit of the earthiness from the tea and the black sesame.
Dude, whoa. Seriously, it's very good.
And look how dark and scary it looks. This is actually constantly moving and changing, dude. We gotta call this like something that you said, something the fold, shadow and bone. Like this is going into the fold.
Into the fold is nice.
All right.
I'm not gonna lie. I didn't think I was gonna like this, but. And I like it a lot.
It's really good.
Throughout the interview, you're like, what is this?
I was concerned.
It's got everything.
Hey,
it's very Asian. Very Asian.
I'm glad. I'm just glad that we impressed the Asian parent on set. That, to me, is an A+, actually.
Asian parent approved.
Well, everyone, this is Lewis Tan and Philip Tan's Into the Fold smoothie. Thank you so much for being here today.
You know where to get it, kids. Come on down.
Shout and Bone is out right now on Netflix. Congrats.
Thank you very much.
On the new season.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
I can't wait to see the disco battle movie. That's what, we'll have you back on for that one. Cheers, everyone.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Cheers, guys.